Chris Wakelin just making him wait for frame two. I bet he could not believe his luck that he got the chance, but he made a nice steely clearance, Chris Wakelin. I was going to say it's nothing Selby hasn't seen before, but that's a very rare event for him to lose a frame like that.
Mark Selby to
remember, the final is best of five.
Fantastic putt there, and a little bit unfortunate with the position.
Chris Wakelin. Touching ball. Oh, miss. Might sell before.
It was only frame one, but the way he was playing looked like he was going to win it, and you could sort of see him running away with it then. Well, the snooker gods are fickle, and suddenly Selby gets a chance out of nowhere.
Looking for a full ball contact on the pink here. Should bring everything into play.
Six.
Still got one to the corner bag, but middle bag, but very unfortunate. Hit them very nice. Could have easily had an easier red than this one.
Seven. 7.
We'll see how far he gets, but I do think, you know, Mark Selby's very good at playing as if it's nil-nil every time he comes to the table in terms of frames. It's a big blow, that first frame. And there's some players in this event, they would have let you know. And you would have seen them stewing and, you know, letting everyone know how upset they were. But there was none of that from Selby. He just sat very still in his seat, very quietly, waiting for Wakelin to return. He would have been very disappointed, of course, but now it's on to this frame. In general, he's playing well. You know, regardless what happened there. He's scoring heavily, looking confident.
Blue's still very much the top scoring ball for this visit, so in Mark's head he's trying to work out a little plan to get that black into play.
60.
Even more difficult now he's finished short on the blue. He's going to have to leave himself a mid-range red to continue the break. To go in and out of balk. He looks to have played that perfectly.
21.
He had very little angle on the blue, but he's managed to come all the way back round for this red. Selby still looking for his first title of this season. He got to the British Open final. Cheltenham, Mott Williams beat him there 10-7. In fact, Williams needed a snooker in the, what proved to be the last frame. Yeah, the kibble's really having to travel, and of course it's harder then 39. To sort of keep ideal position. It's real hard work this break.
39.
has come to an end.
Mike Selby. 39.
It was never easy, that break. It was always just not quite landing perfectly to get that black into play. It would have made all the difference on that that break, having the black on its spot. It would have made cleaning the reds a lot easier.
Just Wakelin 6.
So Selby back at the table, 36 to the good.
Still needs two of these reds to secure the frame. Red followed by black, and
six.
Possibly the red on the right side cushion to follow.
Seven.
Just a fraction straighter than he wanted to be.
40.
Still a massive advantage, 50 points, the way the balls are sitting. And no doubt this red will be getting pushed towards a cushion as well.
Max, I'll be 40. And a miss.
Well, it seemed to hold pretty true, but it just didn't reach.
Bit of a decision to make because it only just needs the red.
So, he should have won the frame. I mean, we said that in the last one, and things went badly wrong, but 62 in front, 51 on. If it happened again, then, well, we may never see him again, actually. But anyway, he's knocked that in, so it's going to be one each. And as I say, he's just sort of reset, hasn't he, after the disappointment of the first frame, just got on with it.
Seven.
you can only play the frame that's in front of you. However many times you replay on your 16, mind the previous one. Chris Wakelin has conceded, so Mark Selby has levelled the final at one each. So the whole 2 days has come down to this one more frame, which is waiting for the two players. Mark Selby and Chris Wakelin will contest the decider in the Group 2 final. 2-2, Wakelin is twice led, Mark Selby is twice hit back. Of course, whoever fails to win the frame, they will come back for Group 3 next month. But the carrot is dangling to get into that winner's group and join Stuart Bingham, who's the first qualifier. 7 places up for grabs. Can be a very lucrative business to get into that winners group with a chance, of course, to win this Championship League and get into the Champion of Champions next season, which is what John Higgins did last season. He'll be in later in the competition. Other players who have entered: Ronnie O'Sullivan, Judd Trump, Neil Robertson, Jack Lazowski, Barry Hawkins. Some real big hitters are on their way. Can show you how the money breaks down. The winner tonight picks up 3,000 plus, of course, all the money they've won along the way. Runner up 2,000. As I say, that winners group is lucrative. 10,000 to the winner, plus all the money that's been won all the way through. So there's a lot up for grabs there. You can see £200 a frame in the winners group, 300 in the playoffs. So, and if you're getting the Champion of Champions, the guarantee there is about 12.5 as well. So, you know, it's an event that sort of starts small but really builds, and chance to pocket a lot of money along the way. Who's your money on then, Ross, in the decider?
Tough one to call. Chris has played very well and so has Mark, so even the form doesn't really dictate someone here.
Well, let's find out. Chris Wakelin to get us underway. Stuck in there well with Selby. I mean, he had the chance to win 3-1. I just thought he was taking a bit of time over things. In the end, he lost his way.
Very handy flick, that one on the brown. Mark can see this red, but almost impossible to get onto a colour. Although he is trying to find a gap. If he can't find a safe spot for the white, he might have to go for this. Checking out the potting angle.
One of those where you weren't quite sure where to look, but it never seemed likely to be a good result for Selby. The balls running round like they were.
Could have actually finished worse. I know he's left two reds on here, but no easy path for the cue ball to get onto a colour. Black's tied up. Probably going to have to play up for the blue here, but ought to be pretty precise with the cue ball here.
One.
A lot of check side on that.
Six.
Remember, Chris Wakelin very nearly wasn't in the group at all. He finished fifth in Group 1, but he could have been relegated. But last match was between Stuart Bingham and Nothin Syncam, and had Syncam won, and it went to a decider, had he won, Wakelin would have been relegated. But Bingham won, of course, went on to win the group, and here he is.
Again, a bit of work to do with the cue ball here. Not ideal. But he'll take that result.
I was going to say, how about now? Well, I don't think the pink actually goes, but blue will.
It's become quite a big ball if he does go for it. It's opened up the pink, so if he can get on that, it can very quickly become a frame winning opportunity. Excellently played. Probably going to have to play back up for blue or possibly green here. Pink's not quite potable yet, although there is a chance here he could play it into right middle, but he would have to be extremely precise to feed the cue ball past the black.
30.
Played that superb, so 80. Now an excellent chance. Pots this red, pink to middle bag, and it then very quickly becomes a match and group winning opportunity.
It
would have been hard fought, he would have expected that, playing Mark Selby. It's in his hands, that's where you want it.
Pink's now available into both black bags, so plenty of choice on where he can place the white.
26. Thirty-three. 39.
An encouraging thing for Wakelin fans, he's not taking his time here, he's just getting on with it. Not overthinking things or looking for problems. Has every reason to be confident coming into this year after the terrific 2023 he had. Who knows what 2024 could bring for him. Never played in the Championship League Invitation version before because he was never high enough ranked. 46. So this was new territory for him, coming in with some real big hitters.
Still going to need three of these reds to get over the line, but couldn't ask for them to be in better positions.
54. I mentioned earlier when he won that shootout, of course it's a different event, 10 minutes against the clock, but he won it in one visit, the final, just one frame.
60.
And every suggestion he's going to do the same here. Two more pots should be enough.
It's going
to be this one, just off the cushion. This is effectively to put himself in the winners' group of this Championship League.
66.
Well, what a great finish from Chris Wakelin. Any victory over Mark Selby is worth savouring, but to do it like this, just one visit needed in the decider, he'll be delighted. And Selby, of course, will have to come back for Group 3.
72. 73.
Can he finish off with a century break?
75. 86.
Not actually made a century in this group, so this will be a great way to end proceedings. All the pressure gone now, of course, just enjoying the moment. And enjoying the way he's won it, most importantly.
94.
So this black then, to end with a century, it's flashbacks to that shootout, isn't it? That's what he did there in this Morningside arena. Just needed the one chance to get it won. It was actually Ali Carter's high break that he beat then. Thankfully for Ali, he can't do it here. The 1-4-2 stands. But the satisfaction is for Chris Wakelin, because he's our winner.
106.
So the break ends at 110, and Chris Wakelin is the Group 2 winner here at the BetVictor Championship League. It was a tough final. He won that first frame after getting the snookers. Led twice. Mark Selby came back at him twice. But one chance needed and one chance taken in the end. Chris Wakelin defeats Mark Selby 3-2, and he will be coming back for the winner's group in a few weeks' time.